A false dilemma fallacy video. A false dilemma fallacy is also known as the either-or fallacy, and it poses a choice between two things without acknowledging any other alternatives. When you just have two alternatives and no other options, you set yourself up for a false dilemma. The false dilemma fallacy is most common when somebody gives an ultimatum. So an example of a false dilemma fallacy is, either you sleep with me, or else I will not love you anymore. This is a false dilemma fallacy because in life, you have many options. So, you know, if you don't sleep with him, so what, right? And if you really love someone, you'll wait for him. So you don't give just two options. So whenever someone just gives you two options, an or else, or some kind of ultimatum, then you create a dilemma. But this dilemma is false because in life, you have many options. Another example of a false dilemma fallacy is, either you obey me in this marriage and agree not to talk to anyone that I don't approve of, or else I will divorce you. Now, here you have a very controlling husband who gives his wife no other alternatives but just to obey him, or else he will divorce the wife and leave the wife with nothing, thus creating another false dilemma fallacy. A wife should have the choice of talking to as many people as she wants without the husband becoming jealous and being so controlling. So to deny someone those options with an ultimatum is to create an atmosphere of fear. So the false dilemma fallacy is also closely tied with the appeal to fear fallacy. In the appeal to fear fallacy, you appeal to the fear of this person, like the wife, fear of divorce. Fear of, oh no, nobody's going to support me. What am I going to do? Or fear of that person not loving you if you don't sleep with them. And so a lot of false dilemma fallacies use fear to control the other person, making the person think there are no other options but to obey that person or but to do what that person wants. And so the false dilemma fallacy and the appeal to fear fallacy are closely related. So when you create an atmosphere of fear. And so in the 2016 election, both Trump and Hillary used false dilemma to create fear in the voters to vote for them. So Hillary Clinton said, either you vote for me or else if Trump gets the nuclear codes, he will blow the world up because Trump is such an unstable, unreliable person. Is this an example of a false dilemma fallacy? Is this an appeal to ethos, pathos, or logos? Does this argument have ethos, pathos, logos, or just pathos? So when you appeal to someone's fear, that is pathos. And so when you have an argument that's based only on pathos, then that is not a valid argument because it lacks logos and it lacks ethos. In other words, it lacks logic and it lacks credibility. So when you hear a appeal to fear fallacy or a false dilemma fallacy, you are merely listening to an argument based on fear, based on emotion, hence the appeal to emotion fallacy also. So whenever someone tries to appeal to your emotions, then it's not a valid argument. And so a very important critical thinking skill is not to believe everything you hear. That is the purpose of all these fallacy videos that I'm making, is to teach students what to believe and what not to believe. So don't believe in anyone who uses an appeal to fear fallacy, a false dilemma fallacy, or an argument based only on pathos, because that is a sign of a controlling person who wants to manipulate your thoughts and manipulate what you think and manipulate how you act. So you need to have your own mind and question everything. That is a critical thinking skill. I am done with this particular video on false dilemma fallacies.